This is Dr. D. Govardhan, Professor in Aeronautical Engineering, Department of Aeronautical Engineering, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering, Hyderabad. Today the topic is in screw jack and the disadvantages of overhauling and application of self-locking. In the previous topic, we derived the effort required for lowering the load by using the screw jack is given by P equal to W tan pi minus alpha, where P stands for the turning force applied at the circumference of the screw, W representing the weight is acting over the head of the screw, pi is the limiting angle of friction, alpha is representing helix angle. The torque required to lower the load is equal to, it is the product of the load applied at the circumference of the screw to the radius of the screw, which is equal to T into P into D by 2 into W tan pi minus alpha into D by 2 now, which is equal to P into D by 2, where P is equal to W into tan pi minus alpha into D by 2 now. In the above expression, if pi is less than alpha, then the torque required to lower the load becomes negative. In other words, without applying the load, automatically the load slides downward directions. Such a phenomena is called overhauling of the screws. If pi is greater than alpha, the torque is required to lower the load will be positive. Or in another words, it is representing some external load that should be applied to lower the load. This phenomena is called self-locking of a screw now. In other words, for self-locking of a screws, the angle of friction should be always greater than helix angle, or in other words, tan pi is always greater than tan alpha. The efficiency of a screw. The efficiency of a screw is defined as the effort applied when there is no friction between the nut and screw and the collar to the load applied by considering the friction between the screw and nut as well as the collar, which is given by N is equal to mu is equal to tan alpha divided by tan alpha plus pi for lifting the load. For condition of the locking screws, pi is always greater than alpha. Hence, it should be equal to, the efficiency should be always for self-locking, it should be less than tan alpha divided by tan alpha minus pi, or which is also equal to when alpha is equal to pi. Since for limiting values, which is now becomes tan 2 pi, tan pi divided by tan 2 pi is equal to 2 tan pi divided by 1 minus tan square pi. Again, on simplifications, we got to 1 minus tan square by 2 or 1 by 2 minus tan square by 2 now. From this equation, we see that for self-locking of a screw, the efficiency of should be equal to 1 by 2, or it should be equal to 50%. If the efficiency is more than 50%, then the screw is said to be overhauling. Differential screw jack. the main application of the differential screw jack is to increase the velocity ratio. In this machines, it consists of two screws which are represented here, A and B. Now, the part A is having internal thread as well as the external thread. That external thread is always accommodated like in simple screws, simple screw jack in a nut, which is the integral part of the assembly as shown in figure. To the screw A, the B screw is fitted into it. That screw B is fitted into the screw A. The A internal thread is meshed with the external thread of the screw B, which is shown in figure. At the top of the B screw, the load is acting. Here represented W and shown in figure. The head of the screw A, it is having 4 volts in order to accommodate the lever for lowering or lifting the load. When the effort is applied at the end of the lever, the screw A rises up. Simultaneously, the screw B moves in downward directions. The lift of the load is algebraic sum of the motion of screws A and B. Now, let P1 is the pitch of the screw A1 and small p2 is representing pitch of the screw B. L is equal to length of the lever arm. W is equal to load lifted. P is the effort applied at the end of the lever as in figure. Then the distance moved by the effort for one revolution is given by 2 pi L, where L is the length of the lever. The upward distance moved by the screw is given by P1 minus P2, where P1 is representing the pitch of the screw A and P2 is representing the pitch of the screw 2 now. Hence, velocity ratio is given by distance moved by the effort to the distance moved by the load, or which is also equal to 2 pi L divided by P1 minus P2. Mechanical advantage is equal to W by P, that is weight lifted to the effort applied. Hence, the efficiency of the screw is defined as the ratio of mechanical advantage to velocity ratio. By using these equations, we can determine the efficiency of a differential screw jack.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.